Yesterday we have discussed about the feature of federalism. What is federalism? Main features of federalism and what makes India a federal country. That is the second chapter of our civics. Now let's revise some of the basic points of federalism and what is federalism. Federalism means existence of two or more level of government. The countries which have central government as well as state government, they are known as federal countries. India is also a federal country. What makes India a federal country and what are the basic features of federalism? Now let's revise the points. In federal form of government, there is existence of different levels of government, and levels of government are central government and state government. In our country, we also have a third tier of government, that is known as local self-governing body or local government. Second feature, the jurisdiction or the area to govern for each level of government is specified in the constitution. The different level of government govern the same citizens of the country, but their area of jurisdiction is different. And on what matters like taxation, legislation, which level of government may class or rules, that is specified in the constitution. Third feature of federalism is fundamental provisions of the constitution cannot be changed by one level of government unilaterally. Yani, jo basic provisions hai, unko kisi bhi level ki government akele change nahi kar sakti. Some provisions require two-third majority to be passed by both level of government. Next is independence of judiciary. In federal country, as we know, there are three organs of the government: legislature, executive, and judiciary. Judiciary is independent from the influence of the government or the legislature of the executive. It has their own jurisdiction and it can take decision at its own. Sources of revenue for each level of government are specified in the constitution, and the federal government has dual objective. First is to safeguard and promote the unity of the country, and second is to accommodate regional diversities. These are the basic features of federalism, and all these features are existed in India, so India is a federal country. Now question arises, how federalism is followed or practiced in India? If we compare the map of India before 1947 and that of after 1947 or after the independence of India, then we can observe that there are a lot of changes in the political map of India. In 1947, State Reorganization Commission was in after the independence of India to create the state boundaries. State Reorganization Commission was established on November 1st, 1956. And this commission is responsible or may have given the responsibility to specify the boundary of the Indian states. In 1947, the first part of federalism that is adopted in India is linguistic states. What do you mean by linguistic state? Linguistic states mean states boundaries are created on the basis of language. Like as we know, most of the Gujarati speaking are living in Gujarat, Marathi speaking in Maharashtra, Tamil speaking in Tamil Nadu, Kannada speaking in Karnataka, Malayalam speaking in Kerala. So in 1947, some old states have changed, new states have been created, boundaries of the states have been changed, so that the people who speak the same language can live in the similar area, so that they can exchange their views or can increase their autonomy. Moreover, all these states in India have not been created on the basis of language. Some some on the basis of their culture. Like, as we know, the culture of our northeastern states is different. The states that have been created on the basis of culture are Nagaland, Uttarakhand, Jharkhand, because these have their different culture. So the first experiment that is followed in India for the success of federalism is formation of linguistic state. Linguistic states kya hai beta? These are the states that are formed on the basis of language, so that the speaker of a particular language can live in a particular area. Now, our second experiment is language policy. What is the national language of India? You know, there is no national language for Indian Union. We have only official languages. India mein kisi bhi language ko national religion ka status nahi diya gaya hai. India mein keval do starting mein official languages humne adopt kiye the, Hindi and English. And it was also decided that the use of English, that was the language of the British. It was decided that the use of the English was to be stopped in 1965 for official purposes. After that, as decided by our leaders, that we will follow only Hindi for our official purposes. But English is used for official purposes till date also. What's the reason behind it? The main reason behind it, that when in 1965 our government decided to ban the use of English for official purposes, then some of our southern states like Tamil Nadu, these have protested, because these states wants to continue the use of English for official purposes. Even today, the southern states are not very much familiar with the use of Hindi. They are much familiar with English. Some protests also arises when we just decided to ban the use of English. Then, after thinking over the matter, our leaders decided to continue the use of English for official purposes. So there is no national language. We have official language, and official languages are Hindi and English. But India is a vast country, and when we count the languages of India, then there are so many languages. According to the census of 1991, there are more than 1500 regional languages or languages that are spoken by the people of India, and people consider that these languages as their mother. More than 1500 languages which people consider as their mother. So after that, reassembling work was made, and after grouping some of the languages, there were made 114 languages. Grouping ki gayi single stream of language ko mila ke, uske baad bhi India mein 114 major languages the. Then what to be done? After that, our leaders decided that we will make some languages as scheduled languages, and there are 21 languages other than Hindi in India that are considered as scheduled languages. Along with Hindi, these are 22, and if we exclude Hindi, then there are 21. Now, what is the main purpose, or what are the scheduled languages? Beta, these are the languages for which are used for examination purposes or administrative purposes in particular area. For example, a candidate who want to compete for central government examination or UPSC or others, then he can opt any one of the scheduled languages as a medium of instruction. जो हमारी 22 scheduled languages हैं, अगर उसमें कोई भी central government या UPSC के लिए exams देते हैं, तो उसमें से किसी भी language को medium of instruction opt कर सकते हैं. This is the importance of second language. And you know, nowadays CBSE exams are going on. And in CBSE exams, all the 22 languages, the exams or the paper of all the 22 languages have been taken. जो gaps आते हैं ना exams के बीच में, CBSE का exam कहीं ना किसी center के ऊपर चलता रहता है. चाहे कोई candidate one candidate एक language में, but exam will be conducted in that particular language. So, our language policy also made India a federal country, because a federal country has dual objective. And what are the dual objective? To promote and maintain, safeguard the unity of the country and to accommodate regional diversity. इसलिए जो हमारी language policy है, जो different language को scheduled language हमने declare किया है, उससे क्या है कि जो एक particular region के नाम है, students and kids हैं, वो किसी भी language को opt कर सकते हैं as a medium of instruction और अपनी language culture को accommodate strengthen करके national unity को enhance करते हैं. So, two points I have discussed about how federalism is characterized in India. One is linguistic formation of linguistic state and second is language policy. Now, as we know that in a federal government, there are two or more level of government. Naturally, one government is for the entire country, that is the central government, and one government for the regional level or for the state is state government. That who